Hi, this is Jaya. Now we shall see the summary of Selected Snowberries by Aldous Huxley. We all know that Aldous Huxley is a genius and is so versatile. Versatile means he knows about many topics. And he lived from 1894 to 1963. And he was a very, very persuasive writer. And his style is very lucid. And it is forceful and elegant. That means what he is trying to say will be easily understood by us. And at the same time, he had a very nice style of writing. And in this essay, The Selected Snowberries, he proves that he can give you a much, much detailed matter in a very, very short sentence. Now, what he means by snowberries is, he means the type of people. We say they are snobs. That is, they will think that they are very great, that they are very intelligent, or they are very handsome, or they very, a lady may think she is very beautiful, and they may look at others as an inferior person. No, they are called as snobs. And here he talks about a few people who are in a particular category. So he has selected certain snobberies. And here he says that in this modern age, mankind is in a very helpless situation. Because he only believes in ostentation, and ostentation means if you are very rich, then you are respected. If you are very beautiful, means you are admired. If you are in a very high rank, in a very big position in any place, means you are regarded as a great person. And he calls that as a snobbery when a person acts in that place with an attitude. And he says that this snobbery is spiteful and it's a nasty habit when a person who is in a higher status or who is better than others looks at others as though they are very inferior and that they are better than others. And he says that most snobbery has only with the idea when the person is rich and when they think that they are worthy than others just because they have money. Now, he says they were snobberies even earlier. That is 100 years ago. But the snobbery at that time, he says, was much better because it enabled people to develop themselves. But he says that snobbery of culture, which was there even about a few hundred years ago, still is there. And at that time, they understood and they were snobs. But now people, they don't understand their culture. But out of ignorance and out of stupidity, they act as though they are very great. Next snobbery, what he talks is about art snobbery. He says it is also a branch of culture snobbery. And he says that this art snobbery is of two types. One is platonic snobbery, another one is unplatonic art snobbery. Platonic art snobbery means those people who take interest in art are called as platonic art snobs. That is, they will know much about the details about arts. It can be painting, it can be sculpture, it can be any form of art. They will know about it. Unplatonic art snobs are the ones who buy this art. That is, if you are going to know the value of the painting or a statue or whatever it is, and if you buy, then you are not a snob. But just to show that you are very rich, you have money to buy it, and for the heck of it, if you are going to buy and keep it in your place, then he says that such people are unplatonic art snobs. And he says, this is done by these snobs because these art collections have a social prestige and they are considered as a wealth symbols. Like if you are having a painting of a very famous painter, then you will be considered as a very rich person. So people buy it only to show to others that they are rich. And most art snobs collect only the works of the dead. That is, he says, great artists, they have died, but their paintings are still in want. And those persons who are very rich, they try to purchase only the art of those who are dead. But some are they who are art snobs. But they patronize the living artist and they provide them with the basic needs because the person who is living now, he has the capacity to produce more. And only when you patronize him, only when you buy from them and only if you are going to take care of them, they can bring out their full knowledge. They can be able to survive in this world and they can produce more of their talent. And then he says the next snobbery is the snobs of picturesque diseases. And he says in disease itself, there are two types of disease, rich disease and the other one is disfiguring and mortal diseases. And he says this picturesque diseases are the diseases of the rich because these snobs who have these diseases, they feel proud to say about it. And some young persons, they even think it is very romantic for them to die young because famous people like Keats and Maria Bashkirtseff, they all died young. So they think just because they have this disease and if they are going to die young, they will also be praised by others like Keats. But at the same time, those who have diseases like disfiguring and mortal diseases, they are not a source of snobbery because no one who is going to have the disease is going to feel greater than others. For example, he gives here about the leprosy snob, which disfigures a person. No one who has leprosy. So even diseases, there are some diseases which are rich diseases, some which are not considered rich. And he says that when you have this rich diseases, you have sufficient time and wealth to travel from one health resort to another health resort. You keep changing your doctors and you go in search of cures from imaginative diseases. Because certain diseases, you will think that you have or you may magnify those diseases. And he says some people who only want to show themselves as though rich and keeps on changing the doctors or who travels from one place to another to the health resorts, he says we need not show our pity and kindness to them. Then next he comes to the modernity snobbery. He says that this is where you give away all your old positions and keep on buying new ones. Even when you can use them, you don't use it only because you feel that you have the money to buy new and whatever you have should be the latest model or a new one. Particularly, even nowadays, the brand snobbery is there. Actually, Aldous Huxley does not mention about brand snobbery. He says modernity snobbery, where you sell away the old ones. After you use it only for a short time and you sell it and you keep on buying it new. And you feel that it's a duty of the man to update himself and have the latest in everything. Or the new product of anything. And finally, he concludes his essay by saying that when you have plenty of snobberies, it is like having plenty of a dog having plenty of fleas in its body. You know, no one likes a dog with plenty of fleas. So he says when you think that you are greater than others and if you're going to look at others as though they are inferior to you, you will not have anyone liking you. So this is how he ends this essay. I hope you've understood the concept. If you have anything to add on, please write it in the description box in your comment. I'll be happy to read it. Like the video, share it with your friends, and if you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe. Thank you.